click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture that we have got to know, we have talked about that is strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. And in that case, we have given an example of strong acid as well as strong base. So now we are going to talk about an individual topic that is based on what is strong acid, what is strong base, along with that, what is weak acid and what is weak base. So let us talk about it. So now talking about the strong acid first. So it is very similar to that of what we have did in the classification of electrolytes, and that was strong electrolytes. And in that case, we have got to know that strong electrolytes are those electrolytes which dissociates completely when they are dissolved in water. So similarly, it is applicable to the strong acid also. Whenever a particular acid that has been dissociated or that has been dissolved in water, it dissociates completely. So since it is an acid, acid will consist of protons, that is H plus ions, and it depends on the theory that on what basis the acid is given its name. And that's the reason that strong acids are those acids which dissociates completely when they are dissolved in water. So for example, if I would say that is talking about strong acid, those are basically HCl as well as H2SO4 as well as HNO3, and all those acids that we know are basically strong acids that undergo that is complete dissociation. So let me give an example that how they are getting dissociated. So suppose if I am talking about H plus or HCl, so therefore if HCl that has been dissociated completely, so therefore it will form H plus as well as Cl minus. So this arrow indicates that once the HCl has been dissociated or is been dissolved in water, it will dissociate completely into H plus and Cl minus. So the main thing is it is called to be acid is because of the H plus ions that has been present in the HCl. So now this H plus ion that has been produced on the dissolution in water or on the complete dissociation, they cannot be turned back to HCl. So that is the reason that they are basically strong acid, and the reason and the thing that it is called to be acid is because of the H plus ions or called as protons that are being present in HCl or H2SO4. That makes them to be called as strong acid. So similarly, we can talk about weak acid also. So weak acids are those acids which similar to that what we have did in weak electrolyte, and in that case basically they don't dissociate completely. So therefore, for an example, if I would say that is for weak acid, that is CH3COOH, that means acetic acid. Acetic acid is a kind of acid which when dissolved in liquid like water, it doesn't dissociate completely. So that's the reason that it has been called as weak acid. It is an acid because it gives us H plus, but since we are talking about the classification of the acid and base, and that's the reason that they are not dissociated completely, and hence they are called to be weak acids. So now let us move on to the next one, that is what is actually strong base, and we'll also talk about weak base in that case. So talking about strong base, so these are the substances which when dissolved in a particular liquid like water, they dissociate completely, and they dissociate completely into their respective cations and their respective anions. For example, if I would say like NaOH or KOH. So NaOH or KOH, suppose if I, this is are the two example, and suppose if I'm talking about KOH. So when KOH is been dissolved in water, it doesn't dissociate partially, and it dissociates completely into that is K plus and OH minus. So now this OH minus that has been dissociated completely when the KOH was been dissolved in water. So this OH minus is the identity that it has been called as the base. So therefore KOH is basically the base. When it get dissolves in water, it dissociates completely, and this OH has no chance to convert back into that is KOH when it has been dissolved in water, and hence that is it has been named as a strong base. And similarly, we could talk about the weak base also. So if I'm talking about a weak base, so like NH4OH, which on dissolution or which on if we dissolve it in water, we could get basically a partial dissociation of that is NH4 plus as well as this OH minus. So since we could get OH minus as a product, and that's the reason that it is called to be base, so that is true, but it is not a strong base, it is a weak base, because once the OH has been formed, so because of the equilibrium or because of the ionic equilibrium that has been established in this process, we could see that this OH can come back to again NH4OH, and we could see that there is no dissociation or not that much dissociation of OH minus, and where OH minus dissociation is the identity to be called it as a base. So therefore this are called to be weak base, and the strong base is what we have got to know over here in the above one. So these are the two things that I wanted to express, and based on this thing we could say that because of the dissociation, a acid and a base can be classified into what is strong acid, what is weak acid, what is strong base and what is weak base. So that's it I wanted to teach in this lecture. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and you share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.